lot of really good music, and if I say, obviously the original music is amazing.
JV's a rock star. What you see in this movie is him performing. That's his voice, that's his guitar.
We recorded a bunch of the songs, and then before we did all of the gig scenes, we'd have band practice on like our day off. Me and all the boys would get together and just, you know, we could play the songs live if we wanted to. I think that was really important so that those gig scenes felt as real as possible.
Adam represents everything that classical music isn't. He's wild, he's rambunctious, he's crazy. And for Mia, she's lived a very rigid lifestyle. And to be a real classical musician and succeed at being a classical musician, you have to have a lot of discipline.
Music is really a character in the movie. Mia's music is very orderly, but the sounds all kind of work together and have taken on a life of their own.
I think it's just interesting watching two people love the same thing in completely different ways. It's a cello and a guitar.
He performed all the songs and he sang them live. He's so good, and it's hard to find someone who can sing, play guitar, and act really well and be cute.
Picking the music was a really fun process, and it gives you an opportunity to enhance the narrative in many different ways.
R.J.'s amazing, and he's just a great director, and his musical knowledge is wild. And every character in the movie, he gave them their own iPod shuffle with music he thought they would listen to. Music as such a powerful character. Say something, I'm giving up on you. It definitely is like the third lead of the movie, and it really does the book justice.
And I'm crazy in love with you.
Please stay.